Thank you.
Hello and welcome to Ponderland. Tonight we are talking about education. Didn't really like education myself. It's just sort of a coercive indoctrination of a brilliant young mind. So I think, do I really need to know all this? But the thing I like best about school is when a teacher don't turn up when you've got a lesson, and for some reason, for some bizarre administrative quirk, there is no teacher for about half an hour. Oh my gosh, the teacher's not gonna come! There's no teacher! There's no teacher! Everything goes a bit mental in Apocalypse Now. People with their ties around their head. Yeah! Like Lord of the Flies or Rambo. Or people, woo, let's go nuts, everybody go crazy. Pull your pockets out like that, get your willy out, do that elephant thing. Yeah, woo, the system's falling apart. But there's always three boffins sat in a row. Well, I think we should get on with our work. This teacher is every bit as irritating as anyone that besmirched my bloody childhood. Look at him, he's a right oppressive tip. He's utterly relying on teaching cliches. Whoa, 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 like dramatised things. Fingers on lips, that bell's for me, not for you. Regarde.
You sure your scissors are closed? Put those into the middle of the table. 2 seconds to crumple paper. One. Two. It's all finished with. Put it in the middle of the table. Second, there it is. No, 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 no.
Now go. Now go 1 second later. What was the whoa, whoa, whoa for? Whoa, whoa, whoa. Like Band-Aid at Christmas time. Whoa, whoa, whoa. And what about that bit where he goes, okay, we've got 2 seconds for crumpling paper. Ooh! Ooh, paper crumpling! Thank you! Oh, tonight I'm gonna crumple like it's 1999! 2000 crumpled paper, baby, out of sight! Some of these teachers here, right, this is a collage of traditional and recognisable teaching archetypes, like, oh, it's the nervous substitute teacher, it's the confident matey teacher, but amidst this lot, there is one I've never seen. Look out for him.
I enjoyed physical education.
Yeah, fancy that one, we had that one.
At the age of 11, I always wanted to teach the subject.
Yeah, we had a teacher like that.
To teach drama.
Yeah, she was insecure, boring, we had him.
I wanted to do a job that
we had one like that. Who's this guy? He's insane! Sean Penn from Carlito's Way. Have a look again and listen to him.
Well, I only went into it, first of all, as a sort of a stopgap.
Teaching was always a kind of stopgap. I was gun running in Ecuador. Had to move a hell of a lot of ice.
Well, imagine having to go to parents' evening with that terrifying teacher.
You're Julie's mum. She's a great girl. She's got rhythm. Danny. Yeah, I like Danny. You can trust him. He's a good driver.
We call him Snake Eyes. Hey, do you want to do a bump?
Can't let him loose in front of children. Although, that bloke is clearly a weird and unusual teacher. I'd much rather have him, that sort of pimp, whore, puff daddy teacher, rather than look at this angry teacher. You know when you're at school and like a teacher sort of jabs your chest when they're telling you off, and you can tell from the way they're telling you off that they've gone a little bit far, and you think, oh, this shouldn't be happening to me. They jab you too hard and a little bit of wee-wee comes out. Look at this bloke here in this clip. He's meant to be the headmaster. His anger is not legitimate. He's completely gone through the looking glass and into his own anger about life. And the whole world that they inhabit seems to be from the Bash Street Kids in the Beano.
Right, MacReady. I said I thought you ought to give a rendering for the rest of them, didn't I?
Sir.
And then you started arguing. And then, when I said, are you arguing with me, you had the effrontery. You had the effrontery.
When you are angry with a child, try not to have any linguistic slip-ups. Be concise. Frontery! You had the frontitude! You had the frontosaurus to frontify me! But then he carries on and reveals he's got a kind of brute henchman's assistant stood kind of behind him. And he gets more and more angry and administers what can only be described as a misplaced punishment.
I want something short and sharp for you, young man. You're obviously too full of yourself. Where's his PE towel?
In the changing room, Headmaster.
I don't want to hold up the lesson. I want him to have a shower now.
Cold shower, Headmaster?
Yes. Go outside. Wait for Mr. Daplin to join you.
Mr. Daplin, I've been expecting you. Boop, boop, be-doo.
It was really unusual. Is it seems that that headmaster is grappling with some inner angst. I think that secretly he's in love with that boy. I'm like, really, if he had his own way, he'd be in that shower with him.
I want him to have a cold shower. I want him to be made thoroughly uncomfortable, but I don't want you to freeze him, all right?
I want you to take that boy up to the West End, dress him up, make him look a real treasure, but I don't want you to fuck him.
He's fighting a very powerful inner force within himself. And also, what's happened in the past with the whole shower freezing situation?
Be careful. The Johnson boys' parents are starting to ask questions.
With teachers like that, the phenomenon of truancy is easily explained. This lad, Patrick Looney, right, which is a lovely name for a school child, can't be easy being Paddy Looney at a comprehensive school, but he is a proper textbook truant. He talks like a 35-year-old entrepreneur, like, yeah, I've got other things to do, I can't get bogged down with it. And also, look at the first bit, how quickly he answers questions. Patrick Looney, Race to Fast Mind.
How do you decide whether you're going to go to school or not go to school?
Well, sometimes I decide at night, or when I get up before I go to school, or on the way to school, I just decide not to go.
Do you know what makes that decision for you?
No.
We're in the morning now, what time will you leave for school today?
We're going at 12.
Why?
Oh, it's so boring. Got a lot of things. I got lots of things to do, and this place is just taking up my time.
This place is just taking up my time.
I've looked at my day. There's this 7-hour period here where it's completely consumed by lessons. I could be getting a lot done. Pretending to my allotment. I've got business deals.
But if you look at Patrick Looney's domestic life, the problem behind his congenital disobedience becomes really, really obvious, right? Look at his mum. Right, here she is. She's got the physical appearance of Olive from On the Buses, but the laconic attitude towards violence of a young Reginald Cray.
The law says it's your responsibility as parents to get your children into school.
Yeah.
Does it worry you when the social workers come round and tell you that?
At the beginning it did, but they can only take me out and shoot me, can't they?
Oh, yeah. They can only take me outside and shoot me. But you better make sure you get me with the first fucking bullet. Or you'll be looking over your shoulder for the rest of your fucking life, mate.
It's really funny, right? The way she approaches her parental obligations as well, right? Because surely, as a parent, the bare minimum you're going to do on a school day is mention to your child that it is a school day. She actually drums it into Patrick Looney. Have a look.
You know, I keep drumming it into every day, more or less.
Every day, more or less. I said, Patrick, you better get yourself to school or someone's going to fucking kneecap you.
Like, when I tried to do a bit of truant, it was always sort of problematic. Look at this letter from my school. Listen to this. It's addressed to my mum, this letter, and she kept it kindly. Following our recent telephone conversation... I can't read. I should have gone to school. I mean, I'm beginning to see now the advantages. Oh, I see. Yes, I would understand. What are these bizarre signifiers and shapes? These peculiar hieroglyphs dance across the page.
There's a sort of a guy like that. Then there's a dog with a pointy face. Then it's just the sun. I mean, what does it all mean?